Hola, hello, and welcome to this, the seventh episode of Super Chats with me, your host, Valeria. First off, we're going to start off with the introductions of the girls as usual. So, Spain, go ahead.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. Greetings to everyone. My name is Aitana Jimenez. I am representing my home country, Spain. And I am accommodation management student, and in my free time, I work as a manicurist.
Hello, my name is Urvashi Oriram, representing Mauritius, and I'm currently a corporate interest administrator in the offshore company.
Hello, Philippines. Hello, world. I am Rachel Ramirez Said, your Miss Supranational Philippines 2019. I'm a psychology undergraduate, and I'm an advocate for gender equality and women empowerment.
Hola, buenas noches. Mi nombre es Nicole Ponce y represento orgullosamente a Honduras. Soy licenciada en turismo.
Hola, mi gente hermosa de Bolivia. Hi, everyone. My name is Marielena Antelo and I'm representing Bolivia. I'm graduated of business administration and also I'm instructor by Zumba.
Hello everyone, my name is Abril Marco and I am representing Argentina. I am a business administration student and I am also a member of the non-governmental organization of hospital clowns called Pasamédicos.
So we're gonna start off this super chat with the usual, our group topic actually. And it's gonna be balance between beauty and brains for the Spanish speaking girls. El tema va a ser el balance entre la belleza y la inteligencia. So anyone has any opinions on it? Because, I mean, we're all beauty queens and we are all part of the stereotype of being just beautiful and not having brains. Anyone wants to start off?
So I know that beauty queens have a lot of, like you mentioned, there's a stereotype that since we're beautiful, that the brains or the intelligence is lacking. A lot of times what people don't get to see behind the beauty and the glamour is the hard work, the strategy, and the effort we put in. In fact, that takes a lot more intelligence, takes a lot more skill to present ourselves the way we present ourselves, to be poised, to know how to work with others, to know when the time is right for certain things. And yeah, that's the balance, really.
I think that also people don't usually see what you guys usually are. Like in your introductions, you said you were this, and that. So people usually don't see that.
Yes, exactly.
Yes, I totally agree with you. I think that it is important for us as beauty queens to show that we are not only an image, that we are not only an empty thing, that we have the possibility to send a message, to have an influence. I think that beauty is important if we are talking about the way we feel with ourselves. I think that it's important to feel comfort with myself. And I like to look myself in the mirror and feel that I'm okay on the way I look. But I think it's much more important the intelligence we have, the relationships we create with others, and the impact that we can have on other persons and the ideas we can exchange with other persons.
¿Me puedes repetir la pregunta, por favor?
Sí, era el tema es el balance, perdóname, entre belleza e inteligencia.
Sí, creo que, bueno, para mí lo que siento es que este certamen es como una plataforma, Valeria, o por algo que nosotros optamos para abrir nuestras mentes, para poder compartir con las demás personas y conocer más de ello.
So for her, the beauty pageants are more like a platform to actually, repíteme después de la plataforma.
Para abrir nuestras mentes y conocer más.
To open up our minds and actually get to know more about people.
Yeah. Claro. Y bueno, aparte de que es una plataforma para nosotros para poder abrirnos como personas, también es una plataforma para llevar el nombre de tu país, para poder llevar lo que es tu cultura, lo que son tus tradiciones.
So besides just being a platform for all of us, it's also a platform for you to actually represent your country, to show the world what your traditions are, your culture.
Yeah. Y además de eso también es una forma de poder ser portavoz de tu sociedad y poder lograr hacer actividades benéficas o de poder llegar a ciertas personas que tal vez nos necesitan. Personalmente, para mí, yo lo veo así.
So, besides that, oh, I lost it, wow. Okay. Repítamelo otra vez, sí.
Bueno, de que además de eso, somos portavoz de nuestra sociedad.
We're also spokesperson for our society.
Yeah. Esta es una manera de poder llegar a realizar actividades sociales.
This is a way to actually being able to realize charity events or social events.
Como lo hago desde hace 3 años.
Like how I do for yeah. 3 years ago.
Yeah. Cuando me capacité como instructora de Zumba.
When she actually got her license as a Zumba instructor.
Yeah. Esta es una forma que yo utilizo para poder ayudar a las personas, no solamente a niños, sino que a asilos de ancianos, a lugares donde acogen niños con discapacidades, a colegios donde también acogen niños con discapacidades. Entonces, yo creo de que para mí esta ha sido una forma y una manera de poder llegar hasta esos rincones de que muchas personas a veces no sabían de que esos lugares existían.
So basically, the pageants have helped her get to places that she's never that she's never been before, or that people don't even know of. And she's touched lives of children, elders, and many people that she didn't thought she was actually gonna be able to touch their lives. So beauty pageants pretty much are just that to you, like a platform to actually get to people.
Sí, ha sido así desde que inicié. El año pasado empecé con los beauty pageants.
She started last year with beauty pageants.
Yeah. Y la verdad que ha sido ya hasta ahora 2 años muy lleno de muchas bendiciones que Dios me ha dado y la oportunidad de poder llegar a muchas personas que me han ayudado a colaborar y aportar a estas personitas también que nos necesitaban. Hablo personalmente de mi pueblo, Riviera Alta.
So basically, she's been 2 years already with the pageants, and it's been a blessing for her. And it's been amazing to get to people from actually from her hometown, Riviera Alta.
Sí.
And basically, it's been a blessing for her and an opportunity to actually get to people that she never thought she would. Thank you. Just so you know, guys, these ladies do understand English, but they feel more comfortable speaking in Spanish, so that's why I'm translating for them. It's not that they don't know it or they cannot speak it at all. So.
And I'm trying to not talk a lot because now I want to. Oh my God, I'm talking a lot.
It's easier. It's not easy to do the switch between two languages. So it's okay. They'll get you.
Thank you.
Bueno, pues parece ser que estamos de acuerdo todas las chicas.
So she says that we are all in agreement.
Y la verdad es que este tipo de certámenes de belleza, aparte de ser una gran plataforma, como estamos de acuerdo todas, también sirve para ayudar a muchas personas de diferentes maneras.
So beauty pageants are not are just a platform that you can actually help other people, like to help other people in different ways.
Con diferentes obras sociales, las plataformas de las redes sociales sirven mucho para no solo para la belleza, para incitar a la belleza, sino la inteligencia y la ayuda a otras personas.
So she also likes using the social medias because they actually help you. They're a very, very good platform to showcase not only beauty, but also intelligence and to also help other people. And okay. So yeah, as you can see, oh wait, we haven't heard from you.
I've been
like stuck translating and oh my God, I'm so sorry. So what about you, Mauritius?
On an ending note, like we are in a beauty pageant, I say that beauty and intelligence works together. Mm-hmm. Like we take care of our body, our physique, like how we do our makeup. One should also educate herself about the fact that is going on today. And because being beauty queens, we are questioned a lot about mm-hmm. what's happening around the world. So I believe that like we are beautiful outside, we need to be beautiful inside. Our brain needs to be beautiful too. So it works together.
I agree. I actually think that there is no such thing as a balance between beauty and brains, because beauty is a total relative concept, and brains is just how do you educate yourself. It just depends on your surroundings, on what you can actually get educated in. Some, we know that some countries are more developed than others. So, but to me, there's no such thing as this balance thing. I actually, this was actually a question or, well, a topic I talked about when I was in Honduras. Es un tema que hablé cuando estuve en Honduras en las charlas. Así que es lindo traerlo de nuevo a la mesa. But, so this is the first segment for the Super Chat. We pretty much just all talked about this whole topic. And now we're going to have a look at what the Miss Supernational 2019 will get as the winner. She will get a home base in Bangkok, Thailand. So let's have a look. And we're back, and now we're gonna do the super fan questions. And we're gonna start off with Miss Philippines.
Oh, hi.
Hey. So your question comes from Clark Kus 9. I hope I'm getting it right. If not, I'm sorry. So your question is, what quality in yourself are you most proud of, and how will you apply that quality if you win Miss Supernational?
What quality? I'm gonna go with a very simple quality of mine, which is, even before I started pageants, I made sure that I'd keep myself grounded and stay true to who I am. And even if that doesn't really match other people's opinions sometimes, I've found that it's really important for me to stick to what I believe in, because it shows if I'm not being authentic with myself, or if I'm not being authentic with the people. So whether it's opinions on the matters I speak, or the matters with my charity or my advocacy, it's really important for me to just simply stay true to who I am. After all, as a beauty queen, I think that's what I'm trying to inspire everyone else to do, and for everyone else to be more like. So yeah.
I agree. I can relate. I'm not the typical queen either. So the next question goes to Mauritius. Yes. Your question comes from Mariam Ahmed Malik. And it's, what makes a millennial woman so special?
Any woman is special, as we are all here sharing this platform. But the woman of the new era, she is a mother, a sister, a doctor, a manager, a miss. We are everywhere. Women is evolving in every field of day-to-day life. And we can see that women is empowering each other. And by finding the light within herself, she is pursuing her dreams. And of course, I would like to quote something that it is really a pageant thing, that women are fixing the crown of each other. So I think that this is the speciality of a millennial woman.
Nice answer. Next in line, Bolivia.
Yes.
So your question comes from Alois. He has like two S's and an X, so
make it sound.
So your question is, What is your insight about body shaming? ¿Qué piensas de las personas que critican los cuerpos de otras personas?
Bueno, yo pienso de que no podemos juzgar a una persona simplemente por el cuerpo.
I think that we cannot judge a person just by its body.
Yo creo de que debemos ir mucho más allá.
I think that we should go much more further than that.
Y valorar lo que realmente tiene la persona como cualidad y lo que lo hace ser una persona única.
And value what they have as quality and what makes them unique.
Que personalmente para mí es como esa persona piensa, cómo esa persona ama, cómo esa persona busca la felicidad.
To me, it's how how that person thinks, how that person loves, and how that person looks for the happiness.
Sí. Y personalmente, yo lo que siempre veo es cómo es su alma de la persona, porque para mí es mucho más importante conocer lo que realmente la persona es por dentro que un cuerpo físico, porque el cuerpo físico no te va a definir lo que realmente es una persona.
So to me, what's more important is to see their souls and to, después de alma, dijiste, oh, because a body is not gonna define the person just like how they are on the inside.
Yes.
Okay.
We are looking at you, Honduras.
No. So, we're done with three girls. We're gonna be up with the three other now, but first we're gonna have a look. Just so you know, the winner also gets a stay in a hotel in Krabi, Thailand. So we're gonna have a look at that now. Contestant is Spain. It's from the same person that has like a lot of S's and X's in his name. So your question is, you had a challenge that's called the influencer, super influencer. For you, what is the purpose of this and why is important?
Okay, thank you for your question. And bueno, yo pienso que este tipo de desafíos en las redes sociales de influencer sirven para ayudar
So I think that all these challenges of influencers help out
para ayudar a las personas
people
de diferentes maneras. I don't know. Pienso que es muy importante porque puedo llegar de alguna manera a ser un ejemplo a seguir para la humanidad.
¿Piensas que te vuelve otra vez? Perdóname.
A ver, pienso.
She thinks that she could get. Oh, she could be a role model for some other people.
Sí, para la humanidad.
For humanity. So influencers, basically, los influencers te ayudan a llegar a personas y ser un modelo a seguir, un ejemplo a seguir.
Sí.
Yeah, so basically an influencer gets to people and he or she becomes a role model for them. Sorry if I sometimes lose in translation, guys. Switching between English and Spanish is not that easy.
Too much languages.
So the next question goes to Honduras. Okay. Comes from Lisabetta. And your question is, who is your role model, speaking of role models, and or someone that you admire a lot? ¿Quién es una persona que admires o veas como modelo a seguir?
Bueno, creo que hay muchas personas que admiro, en especial mi familia, mis personas en Honduras, pero sí como modelo en el mundo admiro a Winnie Harlow.
So I admire my family and the people in Honduras, but as a role model, I admire Winnie Harlow, a model.
Sí, porque siento que es una persona que me eleva las emociones porque siento que no hay ninguna dificultad física que nos ayude a triunfar en el mundo. No hay ninguna restricción para que podamos realizar nuestros sueños.
So she inspires me because I feel that with her, she has nothing that can stop her, not even something physical or anything like that.
Y siento que todas las personas podemos ser un modelo a seguir siempre optando por las cosas buenas o tomando esas cosas buenas de cada uno. Creo que todos y todas tenemos cosas muy buenas.
So, me perdiste. Vuelve otra vez.
Que siento que todos podemos tomar las cosas buenas. Todos
so
tenemos cosas buenas que podemos copiar.
So I feel that we all have good stuff that we can copy from other people because we all share and have good stuff to give to the world.
And finish.
And finish. Okay. And last but not least, we have a question for Argentina. And your question is, what do you think is the best exchange that can occur between human beings to improve relations in the planet?
Okay. I think the best exchange that humans can do to be better is our thoughts, our opinions, and ideas. I think that it's important to listen to each other and to look what is better for everyone, what the common benefit. Sometimes we see things from an angle and we think what we are seeing is right, but we should understand that there's some other people that can be looking the same situation for another side, and there can be seeing things that we aren't able to see. I think that if I give you a coin and if you give me a coin, we will have each other one coin. But if I give you an idea and you give me an idea, we will have two ideas each other. And I think that this is important and that is the best way to develop as a society.
Thank you for your answer.
Thank you.
So there you go, guys. The girls already answered all of your super questions, and thank you for them. But that's all the time we have for today. But remember, before we head out of here, after this chat has ended, you have 24 hours to go and vote for your favorite on the Miss Supernational app and actually help maybe one of these or four of these girls to get into the top 25 on the finale of Miss Supernational on December 6th. So go ahead, get into the app and vote. Bye.
Bye. Bye.